I want to be able to put something out there that shifts, you know, that you know, moment, that mindset, and that sound that, you know, is out already. And, you know, it's not an easy thing to do, you know. I wouldn't say like it's just like a click of a button and, you know, it's done. You know, it takes time, but that's the kind of, you know, producer that I want to be. Reggaeton was the first, you know, door that opened for me to be able to put, you know, my art and my music out there. When I first came into the genre, into the business, I got signed by the Looney Tunes, which were the best, you know, producers in reggaeton music. My first ideas, my first, you know, beats and things that I could bring to the table, it was just a version of them and the people that I admired. And, you know, it was kind of like, if I try this, this is maybe too crazy. They're not going to vibe with it. Like, they're going to think they made a mistake by, you know, signing me. So do I play it safe and keep doing the same thing? Or do I just, like, you know, keep on, like, practicing and developing, you know, my style? Like, what got me here? Maybe, you know, it's a lot of them in that style. But at the same time, like, what I grew up listening to, like, I was still listening to a lot of hip hop, a lot of rock, like, a lot of, you know, even pop music. So how do I bring that into, you know, what I am? So trying to like mix those things, and, you know, it's such a like simple decision, you know, just to like trust what your instinct is telling you. But I'm grateful that I was able to get that, you know, at an early age, and, you know, keep on learning and keep on trying stuff. You know, little by little, I think, you know, we've seen Yandel help me a lot into, you know, the confidence and giving me a sense of trust in what I feel is cool. And I think moving on, you know, J Balvin has helped me, you know, a lot also in diving into different spaces, different sounds. Bad Bunny, you know, that's one that really has, you know, opened a lot of spaces in, you know, in my career, but also mentally. We just sat down for the first time, and without, you know, even talking too much, we already, you know, we're on the same page. We kind of like, without him telling me, I already know, you know, what I need to do, or he's gonna ask for, you know. It's just one track that comes out, and, you know, everything, you know, changes. And, you know, be able to be a part of, you know, I Like It, you know, Cardi and Bad Bunny and J Balvin, was that, you know, experience. And, you know, it was right place at the right time, you know, with the right people. And that opened up so many doors, and be able to work with, you know, Selena Gomez and Justin Bieber and, you know, Shawn Mendes. If it wasn't for that song, I don't think that would have been, you know, possible. So I think that helped me a lot into just, you know, trusting that good music is always going to be, you know, the answer to everything. So working on Un Verano Sin Ti, as always, it's such a crazy, cool, exciting, you know, experience. And I think, you know, this is what, the fourth album in. So it's kind of different from, you know, maybe the first and, you know, some of the earlier ones. But at the same time, it's kind of like, okay, we're back to zero. Like, then I got a sense that he was kind of like in this beach, you know, kind of like more tropical, more happy, you know, vibe. I think on the previous album, it was kind of like a little bit more gloomy, more moody, more, you know, alternative. But this one just like was the other side, and, you know, it was just the perfect timing. You know, we know what was coming up, you know, summer is coming up, like, people just want to have fun. Me also like feeling, okay, he's going this way, let me try this and see, you know, what happens. And, you know, show it to him, and then it's like, oh my God, okay, this is exactly what I was looking for, but I didn't know exactly how to like say it or what it was. And, you know, it's such a cool feeling to say, okay, we're still, you know, it's still that connection there. So working with, you know, with Rosalía is a blessing for a producer. You know, it's such a great experience, you know, collaborating with such a, you know, creative, amazing artist. You know, she really goes into what we do also. So it's kind of like cool, like, not every artist, you know, dives into that. And, you know, going to La Fama, she really likes bachata. But if you listen to her music, you never heard her like do anything like that before. So, in my mind, it's like, what would a bachata sound like with Rosalía? Because I know she's not going to do a, like, super traditional one. Like, it will have a Rosalía sound. So that was the exciting part, like, to see, okay, now we're going to dive into this. What is it going to sound like? So, and she showed us her vocals, but she's doing, like, the guitar. So, you know, my mom's from Dominican Republic, so my whole side of the family from my mom's side is Dominican. So we know what bachata is. So to hear her voice mimicking a guitar, you know, a bachata guitar, it was just crazy, like mind-blowing. And then, you know, we added like a little, I think she had like a little percussion, like filtered, and it just sounded dope. So my thing is, okay, bachata, you need the guitar, you need the percussion, and you need a bass. And bass it didn't have. But I remembered I was working on an idea and it just fit perfectly. It was kind of like, this was done like before, waiting for that moment to just, you know, be placed on the song where it, you know, belonged. And, you know, it ended up being La Fama. So, you know, to have her trust us, you know, and bringing in ideas and learning, you know, it was special. And I think that's something that really opened my mind to what, you know, this album would be. You know, it's just such a groundbreaking, you know, different sounds and things that we haven't heard before, but, you know, brought to the world by this amazing artist. And then, you know, to top it off, you bring The Weeknd in, and, you know, we're all such huge fans of him. And, you know, for the longest time, we've always been saying, like, damn, The Weeknd would sound crazy on a bachata. And, you know, it ended up being that one. So that, to me, is a huge honor. You know, it was really gratifying, learning experience, fun time. And, you know, to see that people accepted it, you know, the way they did, you know, well, what a better feeling, you know, than that. So with this new project, I mean, it's kind of like this gratifying, you know, moment that I've always been wanting, you know, to get to this point since before I even got into music, because it's in Puerto Rico, the culture was that, like, the producers, they did their projects and every artist will come in and just, like, have their own song. And, you know, they want their song to be the best and to shine the best, you know, with this, you know, with the producer from that project. And you'll hear the sound of that producer in different ways because every artist, you know, brings a different sound. So for me to get to this point right now and be able to have my version of what that was, you know, for me to be able to want to do music, it's just, you know, crazy. I wouldn't say I'm thinking about the future of how it would sound, but mostly of, you know, what feels good to me right now, what makes me feel that, you know, whatever I'm doing shows that I've grown, you know, that you know, that I've, you know, been able to gather all this information that I've been, you know, gathering all of these years. How can I put that to the test, but also, like, bring it in a new way? And hopefully when people listen to it, you know, it's going to, like, be something different from what they heard before, especially from me as a producer, but also from what they've been listening to, you know, in these, you know, past couple of years. But at the same time, I just wanted to bring everything that I am into this. And, you know, as I mentioned, people know me as being a reggaeton producer, and, you know, there is a lot of reggaeton into it. But at the same time, it's a merge of, like, everything that has, you know, inspired me in a certain way or helped me get to this point. So I just want it to be the best that it could be. Like, I don't know if I'll have a chance to do another one. Maybe it's this one and that's it. So I need to make this, you know, be the best representation of who I am. But this is going to be, like, just everyone that I'm a fan of, people that I've been working with for a long time. And, you know, those collaborations got us to this point. So, you know, I'm excited for it. So, I mean, Lo Siento Bebé to me is such a special track because of, it's such a cool representation of who I am because of, you know, all the little details starting with, you know, the artist in it, you know, Bad Bunny being one of the people that I collaborate the most and, you know, one of the people that I have the most chemistry with. And, you know, he brings the best out of me, and I, you know, I like to think that I could bring the best out of him too. But I'm happy because, you know, I strive to, like, get what I felt was amazing. So I reached out to Julieta, who I was, you know, a fan of since before I started doing music, which I thought would never even, you know, speak with her because we were such different worlds, you know. She's from Mexico. She's doing, you know, more alternative pop, you know, music. I'm doing reggaeton. So I never thought that a collaboration with her was even, you know, possible because maybe she doesn't like my music or at least what she's heard from me. But I mean, I'm just going to go with it. So I felt as soon as I, you know, had that piano, I knew like her voice would sound, you know, amazing on it. So what I did, I just sent her the piano with Benito's vocals on it. No drums, no anything. As soon as she got it, she was like, "Oh, amazing. Yeah, like I'm excited. Like, thank you." And I was like, "Oh my, like this is crazy. Like, here's something that I thought was impossible. Now it's on the track that I'm about to put out from my project." And so, you know, it was a cool experience because Benito doesn't even know that I'm trying all of this, you know, in the background. Because, as I mentioned, I wanted it to be connected to the song, but maybe not exactly in the song. So I, as soon as I have it, I just send it over to him. And then he starts listening to this woman on the end. And he's like, "My God, that's Julieta Venegas. Like, that's crazy." And it was his idea that he said, like, "It's so perfect, it needs to go on the beginning. Like, it has to go there." But the thing is, like, for me, I was saying, okay, like, then I start thinking how I'm not supposed to think, like, it's too long, like, people won't play it, like, maybe the radio or the club or whatever, it's gonna be maybe an issue for you to come in so late, or, you know, the hook to come in late. You know, he's like, "Nah, leave it how it is." And, you know, once again, and it keeps, you know, showing me the genius in him of, like, if it just feels perfect, just leave it like that. It doesn't need changing or adjusting. It doesn't matter if it doesn't conform to what, you know, the radio, how they would play it or the club. Like, if it's dope, they're going to play it. Like, it doesn't matter. And at the end of the day, that's how we supposed to, you know, think about music. Like, if it's cool to you, it sounds amazing to you, doesn't matter if it doesn't go with the normal standard. Like, it's just cool. And, you know, it ended up being something great. People, like, really get into, you know, the beginning and that journey onto getting to the point of the hook and then having Benito come in. It could have been better than that, you know, and better, a better way to start off, you know, this journey of me working on this project. So grateful for the both of them. And, you know, for it to be recognized by the Grammys, it was crazy. I didn't expect that, you know. It was cool to be nominated, like, for me, like, wow, we got to a point where, okay, we got nominated for the track. But to see that it won, like, I wasn't ready to go up there and just, like, say thank you for that or you know, any of it. You know, I was just happy to be, you know, a part of that. But, you know, it just goes to show that, you know, again, believing in you know, who you are and what's true to you and amazing to you, just go with that. Like, to anybody that wants to do, not even just music, whatever they're doing, just, like, go with whatever feels good to you. It's going to move people differently than just giving them what you think they want. So, you know, it's been amazing.